In this video, we're continuing on with the more properties of exponents worksheet or properties of exponents hard on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section, picking up where we left off with number 9. Remember that any base raised to a power of 0 is equal to 1. So x to the 0 is 1, so we have 2 times 1, which is 2. So I'll rewrite this as x all over 2 squared, which 2 squared is 4, so we have x over 4 in number 9. Continuing on in number 10, we have 2m to the negative 4 all over 2m to the negative 4 to the third. So let's start by distributing that exponent of 3 to the 2 and to the m to the negative 4. So we'll have 2m to the negative 4 all over 2 to the third times m to the negative 4 times 3. That's equivalent to 2 times m to the negative 4th all over 2 to the 3rd, which is 8, times m to the negative 4 times 3, which is negative 12. So now I'll simplify. 2 divided by 8, 2 goes into both 2 and 8 evenly. So we can write this as 1 over 4, since 2 divided by 2 is 1 and 8 divided by 2 is 4. So we'll have m to the negative 4 minus a negative 12. Since m to the negative 12th was in the denominator, that exponent is subtracted. So for our final solution, m to the negative 4 minus negative 12 is m to the negative 4 plus 12, which is m to the positive 8, and that's all multiplied by 1. So we'll have m to the 8 all over 4. Continuing on to the second page with number 11, as opposed to starting by distributing that negative 1 exponent, I'm going to put this entire term on the bottom of my fraction in the denominator because the exponent associated with that quantity is negative. So I'll have 1 all over 2m squared and that quantity to the first since I made the exponent positive. However, when we raise any quantity to the first, that's just the original quantity. So we'll just leave 2m squared, and that will be multiplied by m squared. So that's equal to 1 over 2 times m to the 2 plus 2 when we use the product rule. So that's 1 all over 2m to the 4th, since 2 plus 2 is 4. In number 12, we have 2x cubed all over x to the negative 1 raised to the third power. So I'll have 2x to the third all over x to the negative 1 times 3 when I use our power rule for that exponent of 3. So that will be 2x to the third all over x to the negative 3. Now, since the exponent associated with x is negative in this denominator, I'll move it to the numerator. So I'll have 2 times x to the third times x to the third. And x to the third times x to the third, I can write as 2x to the 3 plus 3. So I'll have 2x to the 6th as my final solution in number 12. And 13 is really simple. Because I'm taking this entire quantity, a to the negative 3 times b to the negative 3, and raising it to the 0, any quantity raised to the 0 is 1. So in number 13, our solution is 1. For number 14, you can see again that I have a quantity raised to the 0 power. So that entire quantity is equal to 1. So the only thing I have left in number 14 is x to the 4th times y to the 3rd. And number 15, I have ba to the 4th times 2ba to the 4th to the negative 3rd. So at the start, I'm going to make this exponent positive by moving the entire term associated with that exponent into the denominator. So I'll have ba to the 4th all over 2ba to the 4th raised to the positive 3. So that's ba to the 4th all over 2 to the 3rd times b to the 3rd times a to the 4 times 3. So that will be b times a to the fourth all over 2 to the third, which is 8, times b to the third times a to the 4 times 3, which is a to the 12th. So now, rewriting my like bases, I'll have b to the 1 minus 3, taking into account b to the 1 and b to the third that was in the denominator, that will be multiplied by a to the 4 minus 12. And that's all over 8. B to the 1 minus 3 is b to the negative 2, and a to the 4 minus 12 is a to the negative 8, and that's all over 8. However, now my exponents with both my base b and my base a are negative, so I'm going to put those on the bottom as positive exponents. So I'll have 1 all over 8 times b to the positive 2 times a to the positive 8. So 1 all over 8 times b squared times a to the 8th. And now onto the last problem that I'll complete in this video, number 16. In number 16, I'm going to simplify at the start because x to the 0 I know will equal 1. And because this exponent is negative, I'm going to put the entire quantity within the parentheses into the denominator with the positive exponent. So I'll have 2y times x to the positive 3 all over 2y squared raised to the third. Now I'll distribute that exponent in the denominator. So I'll have 2y x to the third all over 2 cubed times y to the 2 times 3. Now, as opposed to calculating out 2 to the third, I'm just going to subtract that exponent from my base of 2. So I'll have 2 to the 1 minus 3 times y times x to the third all over y to the 2 times 3, which is y to the sixth. So now I'll have 2 to the negative 2 times y to the 1 minus 6, and then I'll multiply that by x to the third. Now, you can see that 2 to the negative 2 has a negative exponent, so I'm going to write that in the denominator. So that will be 2 to the positive 2, or 2 squared. And then y to the 1 minus 6 is y to the negative 5th, since 1 minus 6 is a negative 5, and that will be multiplied by x to the 3rd. Now my y is negative, so I'm going to move that into the denominator. So I'll have x to the 3rd in my numerator all over 2 squared, which is 4, times y to the 5th. So x cubed divided by 4y to the 5th is my solution in number 16. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.